Flight. Mankind's first dreams. To take to the sky. See what is below us. See what the birds can see. Be able to fall and have no fear. For a long time, man tried to take to the air. Be able to touch the clouds. To go beyond the clouds. Here will follow a special man. A man with an incredible gift. A gift of destruction. Yet the gift has granted other uses. With his gift, he can soar the heavens and perhaps be able to see his brother. This man's name is Okiyasu. This man likes to say Oijosuke. This man likes mineral water. And this man will teach us the science of flight. For this is the rocket science of Za Hando. Alright, enough of that. Today we're going to be doing some rocket science to see how big brain Okiyasu really is.
I dream of a genie. I would like to brown feathers.
Today we're going to make a rocket man out of Okiyasu. Believe it or not, I'm a civil engineer, so I know the magics of steel and concrete. But this big science requires a little bit more than concrete. It requires a big name. Another fellow engineer to handle Za Hando. If only there was a nuclear engineer around here.
Have no fear. I am here. I heard we needed some heavy-duty science. I happen to be around in the neighborhood. I'm ready to dissect the many layers of mathematical complexity. In fact, I just used the knowledge of Einstein to figure out Okiyasu's Za Hando in my own video, which you should definitely check out.
Whoa, a wild Shuckmeister up here? The man, the myth, the legend? The man that made that controversial A Rocky Forgot video? The man that does stop motion with JoJo figurines? Which I've heard that one's coming up soon. Folks, we're playing with some fire, cause this is our most controversial guest yet, and it's a privilege to have him on the show today, baby. Taking one of NASA's finest men, we can now assemble the Avengers of Science. Today we'll learn about the speed of sound, then some pressure and energy, and lastly we'll top it off with some Rocket Science 101. Also, this is my voice. I know. Amazing. It's a dream come true. Let's learn. First we're gonna do some quick math about the speed of the- As you can see, it produced the sound.
You know, I love acoustical physics, but we're not looking at any Riemann curves. In space, you can't hear any sound. Cars will never hear the glory of Za Hando, and that's because you need a medium for sound to travel through.
A medium is anything made up of atoms. Now we're gonna take a look at today's equation. Relax, relax, take a breath. We're gonna be talking about air. Good old oxígeno. A lot of these numbers are gonna be the same. So a lot of these variables are going to be constant. Now, all we have to really care about is temperature. And an average summer day in Japan is 68 degrees Fahrenheit, which is equal to 293 Kelvin for all of y'all that are keeping track. Throw them all into the equation and boom, we get 343 meters per second, which is the same as the speed of sound. Proving that Za Hando is going at the speed of sound. Wow, what a discovery. Chalk that up in the archives for that one. Now we're gonna explain Josuke's teleportation when he fights Okiyasu.
With sword shield wormholes, right?
Yes, but no. Instead, we'll use the principles of pressure to explain Josuke's jump using Bernoulli's equation, named after the Swedish mad lad Chad Jacob Bernoulli, for he's the one that discovered the letter E. This is an important number when you're talking about money. So pay your respects whenever you use the letter E. Basically, Bernoulli's equation says that energy is the same before and after an event. And this event that we're going to talk about is Za Hando. All that energy can be found in pressure, speed, density, height, and gravity. This was true, until an Einstein said that energy can also be found in mass. But we don't have to worry about that because the change is very little. Negligible, as they say it in the industry. Just before Za Hando, Josuke experiences high pressure, but then that energy transfers over to low pressure, plus a very high speed, which explains his jump. So I tried working out the math and I added some pretty big assumptions. And I found out that the pressure that makes Josuke go very fast is over 200 atmosphere. To give you some perspective, we comfortably live in 1 atmosphere of pressure. There are reports that people have survived at 100 atmospheres, but there's no way that you could survive with 200 atmospheres. In conclusion, Josuke died.
Rest in peace, Josuke. You will be missed. But we can also solve this using energy principles found in thermodynamics. I know, thermophysics. We hate it. We all hate it. It's gonna trigger my PTSD. But since we're talking about energy, oh god. Oh no. Not Fourier heat transfer through a cylinder!
Yet, in the battle with Josuke versus Okuyasu, it looks like Okuyasu was the only one hurt with those flying flower pots.
Speaking of flying, it's time for some flight simulation.
It's time for some rocket science. Having designed some aircraft structures myself, we're gonna teach you the basic forces of flight. There's 4 of them, like an avatar. Except it's not fire and wind, it's with flip, thrust, drag, and weight. This is true with all flying objects. Hot air balloons, airplanes, rockets, all of them, bro. It's a wash. Here we have Okuyasu in the air, chasing Red Hot Chili Pepper, who's in the motorcycle. And here we have all the forces that are being present right now. And here are their respective equations for each of these forces. And here we have the head of Okuyasu going through a virtual wind tunnel to help illustrate how air works.
Yo, Josuke!
All we need to know is that Okuyasu is moving upwards and onwards, meaning that his thrust is greater than his drag, and his lift is greater than his weight. The movement of Okuyasu can be described by the classic F equals MA by none other than the British mastermind Isaac Newton. Going back to those complicated equations, they're all just F equals MA, but they look a lot more different, and that's pretty cool. Even though it's complicated, Okuyasu seems to understand a lot of these principles, proving once and for all that he is big brain. I mean, who else can hold Stray Cat and live to tell the tale? Only Okuyasu. And Okuyasu's dead, but hey, it's neither here nor there.
With that, I think we can call it a day.
I agree. It's time to wrap it up for this video. But my boy Shuck, he's a modern man in a modern world with a modern explanation of Za Hando on his channel. Go check it out, and in the comments, say something from Elton John's Rocket Man, which kind of inspired the idea for this video. It's a good song, trust me.
And don't forget, have a beautiful Duang, and subscribe to this channel.
And I think it's gonna be a long, long time, till touchdown brings me round again to find I'm not the man they think I am at home. Oh, no, no, no. I'm a rocket man. Rocket man. Burning out his fuse out here. Alone.